It is interesting to me how something someone says stays with you, and you continue to remember it for days, weeks, months, and even years later, while forgetting most everything else you've heard. To the great chagrin of my chaplain and preacher friends out there, who have no doubt preached countless sermons, I'll pose this question. Or maybe it would be better to ask your parishioners this question. How many sermons or things said in a sermon do you actually remember the next day, week, month, or years later? I can't remember most of what I have heard in sermons over the years. I was with Kate when she toured Ireland in 1997. One Sunday morning, I got up and went out for a walk on the streets of Dublin and came upon a Baptist church, so I decided to go inside for the worship service. I can't remember what the inside of the church looks like, nor can I remember anything about the music. I don't know if they sang hymns or contemporary worship songs. In fact, I can't remember anything at all about that church except for something the preacher said in his sermon. He was talking about grace, and he told a story from his hometown about a woman who went to see the movie The Sound of Music every single day for several years. How could I forget a story like that? He said that the woman knew all the songs by heart and would sing the songs often, but the one she sang the most was a song titled Something Good. The lyrics say, "For here you are standing there, loving me, whether or not you should. So somewhere in my youth or childhood, I must have done something good." The preacher said that the mindset presented in this song, that you must have done something good in order to receive a blessing, is ingrained into the Western mind and culture, and thus the reason we have such a hard time comprehending grace, which is freely given and never earned. Nothing comes from nothing, the song says. Nothing ever could. So somewhere in my youth or childhood, I must have done something good. It makes for a nice sentiment in a beautiful movie. You can't argue with that. But when it comes to grace, it misses the mark, which is something that all of us have done. We have missed the mark, and thus our great need for grace. I am so glad that I just happened upon that little Baptist church in Dublin, Ireland, 25 years ago. Thanks for listening, my friend. May grace and peace be with you always in your journey of life.